And today I'm going to do a special live edition of Rob's Random Roms. Now, generally speaking, what this is where I set Google's random number generator to 547, which is the number of NES ROMs that I have, and then I go on ahead and I play whatever number it lands on. Now, I have played quite a few of these in the past. They are on my YouTube channel, which, let's see if we can bring that big, that beautiful little banner up. Boop! So go to that link over there if you want to see what the whole fuss is about with Rob's Random ROMs. Now, I have, as you can see, Google's random number generator, which, wait, you can't see it. Sorry. I was trying to get it to find that image, but it's not. So, sorry guys, you don't get to see me actually roll for the random ROM. You'll just have to take my word for it. So let's go on ahead and hit that button. I came up with 246 out of 547. And then what I do is we just go down the list here. 247, I believe, is what I said. Ooh, Mega Man 4. Now, I have played Mega Man on this stream before, and I've played Mega Man 2 on another stream, so we'll try and see what that gets us. So, I do want to thank whoever dropped in here. While I may not be able to watch you on my computer, I get the phone, which just went to T-Mobile for some reason, which is dumb. So we gotta go to Mega Man 4, and then we hit that button. Capcom presents AD200X. It seems like there should be more noise. I've also got a problem with my headset where it has to be plugged in. That might be why I can't hear anything. Oh, I had a little speaker that I was using to help me listen to everything and help me hear everything. Let's go back to the surround sound. There we go. I'm gonna turn down that audio just a smidge. Oh. Ah, crap. I've got to add that back in because the one that I was using. See? Now you can see Mega Man 4. Yeah, you don't need to see the Twitter symbol. The world fell into total chaos. Dr. Light quickly realized that the mad scientist Dr. Wily was behind the nefarious deed, but he didn't know what to do. Rock, having... Sorry, this is going to be kind of loud. A strong sense of justice and volunteered to be convinced Super Robot Mega Man. I got Oreos. Mega Buster, huh? I can't see if everybody else can see, but Skull Man. I've never had. I remember. Oh, look, it's a Skullsman. I tried to jump over him. That didn't really work out, but I'm gonna kill that flippy little shield. Haha! Dead! Screw you, bat! Oh, crap. Back to full health. I can't get that. He can't duck either. No duck. No ducking. That's bull. I don't know what that was. Energy. That helped a little. I'm about to die. I don't want to die. Damn it. Also, just let everybody know, I bought a new game today. I bought South Park, The Fractured But Whole. And I do plan on streaming it. Hey, I killed him that time. Damn it. That worked. Oh, I need to go get that. Oh, the slide. No little red trash can to help me? Fuck. You know what? I'm not even gonna mess with that part. That cost me my life last time. I don't need it. Okay. Ah! Eat a jar of unmentionable things. Oh, this is not fun. You don't have the height to make the jump. Okay. Oh, straight into the abyss. Dang it. Oh, hang on. I'm gonna update the, Sorry, everybody. I try to be as accurate as I can. Man. There we go. Now we're back. Sorry. I just want to make sure that all my... all my ducks are in a row on this one. I mean, I doubt I'm going to be breaking any speedrun records, but... Missed. I think I'm about to go face Skullsman. Better take the opportunity now to charge up. Damn it. Kind of had to tank that one. Oh, look! Yeah, it's not great, but it's a lot better than it was. Man, the runtime on that is far too short. Start DPSing. Damn it. Hopefully they'll start me there. Oh, game over. We're going to go after the Pharaoh. You have to choose between shooting at him. I don't think I can make this one. I think you need a power up already. You can't take him. Those flies. Oh my God, I'm getting wrecked. Going after the Pharaoh was a bad choice. Oh, it switched to Toadman, even though I was going to go after Ringman. Them birds, though. What am I... I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I can't shoot up. I cannot point directly up, so I can't shoot them as they come down. Getting dive bombed from both sides and slowed down by something. I don't even know. What the hell? We're going to do something a little different. Okay. Just because I now have this ability. Also, if I ever get past, 5 viewers, I want to get it to where I can press a button and it'll start a random dance party. This is one of my favorite songs by Alter Bridge. I gotta turn it down on my headset as well. There we go. Gotta put your... Sometimes you just gotta put yourself in the right gaming mood, right? I think I'm pulling that jump a little short. Well, the servant is not a messiah to the night. The woman's body divided to fire. Singing, no, no, no. I missed that gap. Wow. Show me nothing but that won't compromise. Show me a little that hope can survive. I'm getting wrecked here. Really? Yeah, my phone's down to 15%, so we might be doing only a half an hour. Wow. I think I gotta kill that thing. couch. Don't respond. You respond. Show me your little hand. Come on, ma. It's following me. Make it go away. Uh-oh. Damn it, the crosshairs. It's so bad. Yeah, nope. I can't even stay at the beginning of it and get away with it. Get away from that one. Okay, so got half a bar on that one. I think it only played that song, which is terrible because I like all of my music. Let's play something funny, shall we? I've had a bit of a long day. Oh no! Get left. Get up the ladder before it shoots. Good. Good, good, good. No! What the hell? Let's get recoil in here. Oh, screw you, game. Six words long. This song is just six words long. This six words long. Oh, you. Oh, come on! Let's have his arm at a fixed radius, which is just straight ahead. Don't give him a directional, which you give to every other enemy. I mean, I don't hate this game. I kind of like it. Because the challenging... The difficulty curve for what it wants to do, what it knows it can do, and it tries to be, you know, something not maybe terribly complicated. No, I'm just gonna let it kill me. Oh, it can't kill me. Because of where I am on the... Every other one was able to shoot lower than that. See? It won't hit you on the floor. See? No. I've done this for 30 minutes. And normally I only do 10. So I already have Oh no! No! Screw it. Tanking it. Oh, come on. Oh, that wasn't fun. Oh, no. I think I know what it is. See, I had an extension plugged into my NES controller that Will from Peace Loving Guns thoughtfully sent to me for Christmas. Merry Christmas. Get to start that one over again. Yeah, that could have gone a lot better. And my phone's just died, so not able to stream this. What the world? No! Oh no! Ah! I don't. I ain't trying to get hit. And you absolutely can for that song. It's a good thing I know pretty much every song that's in my playlist. Like, I know the first couple seconds of every song. So I'm like, oh, I know which one's this one is. Oh, I messed that up. There we go. Well, that'll be great. That's gonna screw me over, though. Let me go. Sorry. I know it sucks when I try to do this. Sorry, I gotta go to my dashboard so I can fix everything. I appreciate you guys being so patient with me while I play probably bad, like the worst music. Again, I really want to say I'm very thankful to everybody who, you know, watches my channel and keeps up with me. You guys are awesome. And if you want to, feel free, go ahead and write to me in the chat. Radio and video by System of a Down. I can't remember. You know, as they say, better safe than sorry. Oh no! Oh well. It's all part of the choices that we make. Oh no! Forget the sorrow when I will be on the last train home. Half the day as it fades away, no more time to win, no more time to play. 'Cause we, if we're going nowhere. I hate making choices like that. Oh, that's gonna screw me over. Should have went straight up and down on that one. Like I did with that one. We're gonna get there. I'm kicking Dr. Mario ass. Oh! Bush. Oh, no. One mistake and I'm starting to go belly up here. And I'm not intentionally tanking it this time. Oh, wait, I might take advantage of that. Boom. Boom. That'll get rid of those guys. Which will give me the option to free that up. And I don't want to waste those, because you never get those. Boom. Let's put that there. This is an old band right here called Rhenium. They don't play anymore. They were a local band in Houston. And I loved them. I love their work. Nope, not that one either. Not that one either. Okay. Two ICP songs in a row. It's like, no. Come on, Rob. You don't want to do that. I loved playing Tony Hawk Pro Skater back in the day. No! Crap! Nope, not gonna do it. Come on, Doc, stop throwing me the pills I don't need. Start throwing me the ones I do. I don't need any more blues. Got him rid of that. That's something I needed. Around the telephone pole, come on. There we go. This is Evanescence, I believe. Yep, Tourniquet. Okay, no problem. Okay, I think we did fairly good for a first attempt, you know, first time we've ever tried this, first time we ever went this direction. I would like to report that PW Insider, Ryan Satin, Pro Wrestling Sheet, and all the big wrestling news sheets are reporting that Vince McMahon has reportedly sold $105 million worth of WWE stock and has officially registered XFL as a trademark once again. Now, for those of you who are not young enough, who are not old enough to have remembered the first time he tried this, what it was Vince McMahon, as on behalf of WWE, attempted to form his own football league. He had a very unique coin toss in that they rolled the football along the ground and whoever came up with it first got to decide who, you know, who going forward would receive or kick. They played on the same regulation field. They played the same rules. It was very smash mouth football accordingly for the time. But the big thing was that the league was formed with a couple teams, and Houston had a team, the Texas Terrors. I remember I wanted a jersey for the Texas Terrors. I wanted to go to one of their games. Houston had a team on this league, and we never got to go. I never got to see it. I never got to get a jersey for them. Seriously, look into it. I'm not lying to you. I'm not making this up. This was a thing. Vince McMahon made a football team. In fact, to illustrate my point, not news. Yeah, no, I mean, XFL, let me... I wish that I could make this up, but I'm not. In fact, I'm about to bring up the image. Hang on. It's not a great image, but it's the first one that I found that was the logo. Yeah. I mean, what do you say about that? That was a thing. The Las Vegas Outlaws had one of my favorite players just because of his name. I didn't get to watch all that much because I was younger and therefore I was not allowed to watch XFL because they came on later in the evening and I had to be doing homework and doing other school-related things, and they were called the Las Vegas Outlaws, and my favorite player's name was He Hate Me. Don't know why, just the name caught me, but yeah, no, this is coming back. Jesus. Just, what do you even do with that? I kid you not. This is a thing that's going to happen. This is a thing that's in the works. Vince McMahon is putting himself out there once again to try and become, a mogul in a field that already has a pretty dominant force. I mean, you can't really do much against the NFL and hope to, you know, make headway. It's just, it's crazy that this is being attempted, that this is being even tried. Because you shouldn't try this, Vince. This is a bad idea. It was a bad idea the first time. It's not going to be any better now. But He's gonna do it. I gotta change it. But no. Like I said, it's like, And especially if you look at some of the things that WWE has done this year, that they have openly admitted that they're doing. They're cutting back the pay-per-view schedule, which is good. We didn't need all those pay-per-views. It wasn't really necessary. It was like one every couple weeks. It was a pain in the ass to try and watch any of it. And not all, none of it, and so few, so little of it was good. I mean, for me, okay, Elimination Chamber, like, if I were to write the calendar, Royal Rumble, WrestleMania, Survivor Series, SummerSlam, those are four that are absolutely staying in. Money in the Bank, all right, fine. You want to have that, go ahead. Not going to stop you. Knock yourself out. Elimination Chamber, fine. If you're gonna have the brand split, if you're gonna do that, keep Elimination Chamber. If not, you need to get rid of it and replace it with a different pay-per-view that isn't gimmick. I think they should get away from, oh, we're gonna have a match that's titled after, or we're gonna have a match that matches the theme of the pay-per-view, like Hell in a Cell. No. You don't need to do that. Bring in something different. Go ahead and they own the rights to WCW. They could do Bash at the Beach. They could do Halloween Havoc. They could do King of the Ring. They could do Starrcade, which they did. They did as a flipping house show for whatever reason. I mean, come on, people. You don't have to do it. You don't have to have a theme pay-per-view and then go after just that match for the main event. No, do something else. Come up with a new name. They did Great Balls of Fire. Yeah, it was hilarious, but especially because there were many images that surfaced that showed the shall we say finer points of the male anatomy as part of the logo, kind of veiled and hidden, but if you looked at it, you knew. And it's like, okay, really? But I love wrestling. I do. Some of my favorite wrestlers in the world are currently associated with World Wrestling Entertainment. They're not allowed to do everything I know they can do, or everything I'd hope for them to do, but I will enjoy the product all the same, because we, as you know, consumers have to sort of kowtow and give ground that we're not always going to get the dream match just because they have something else planned. But it would be nice if they didn't decide to do something that absolutely failed. I mean, for God's sakes, the apparently, like, if I remember correctly, the winner of the winning team, if you made MVP of the bracket, like the whole tournament, in you won their Super Bowl, the MVP got $1 million. It's a lot of money. And the problem with trying to create an alternate football league at all is that, A, finding investors and capital is going to be very difficult, because everybody's going to go, how is this different from the NFL? How is this going to make us as much money as the professional National Football League that has been around for the better part of 100 years? You can't say it. You can't have that and step forward and say it's going to be better. What are you going to say? You can't. Oh. See that little pile back there? I got a new pop. I got the turret from Portal 2. I was just thinking about going and getting it and bringing it up here because I saw it on the stream. But it's so difficult to love something and see it do what it's doing. See the company, see the chairman. I mean, he was there. He knew. He pitched this idea the first time around and it failed. You can't do that. It cannot be done. Don't do it. Hell, if I was Vince, I'd be planning for retirement. He's pushing 70. In fact, I'm pretty sure he's either like 65 or 55 or something like that. Let's do a quick quick fact check through our dear friend. He's 72. He's 72. You know what? As much as I hate to face the fact of my own mortality, I'm 32. He's 40 years older than I am. And we only have a finite amount of time on this planet. And yes, Vince McMahon takes great care of himself. He's in wonderful shape for a man of his age. Especially when you consider Mick Jagger's not much old. Steven Tyler's not much older than Vince. Ric Flair, everybody loves Rick. Rick nearly died last year. He's only 68. Vince is not going to be around forever. The keys to the kingdom are going to go to Paul White, a.k.a. Triple H, Hunter Hearst Helmsley, with Shane McMahon also taking his piece. But I think Shane doesn't want that much. He did his thing. He owns a different business. He has his cut somewhere else and can make millions of dollars doing other things. But now he's back. Why? I think it's because he senses the time is getting close for Vince to start stepping down and to finally go away. And when Vince is gone, what are we going to get? Who's going to run the show? It's going to be Triple H. And I think he's going to want Shane there. Because Shane is a good businessman. I don't think Stephanie's going to want to do it much after Dad steps away. Hell, she's barely on TV as it is. She took one bump at WrestleMania. Wasn't seen for months. She fell into a table, one of their collapse away tables. Wasn't seen for months. Didn't come back until, I believe, about 2 months ago. I mean, she doesn't want to be on TV anymore, unless she has to be. Or maybe she didn't. Maybe she just wanted to step away from TV for a while, you know, recharge her batteries and come back when she felt the time was right and the storyline called for it. Maybe I'm just, you know, being too critical, but I doubt it. I want to see Vince finally retire on TV right after The Undertaker. Because that's coming. If it doesn't come at the 50th anniversary show, which is coming up very soon. I mean, hell, I was working today at my second job, and because we dispense DVDs, I was over by the real life documentaries, and one of the things I saw was 50 years of WWE. It was a 3-disc special for about $7. I didn't pick it up. Because I'm waiting. I'm waiting for the Ultimate Undertaker collection. It's going to be there when he retires. And if that doesn't happen very soon, like right before WrestleMania, if he's not in the Hall of Fame, soon as he turns around, hangs it up, because he's not coming back this year. He's not going to come back again. I think that Mark Calloway, once he got that hip surgery, yeah, he might have felt better than he's felt in years, but I think that's about it. He's done. Hell, I want to see him roll out at the Hall of Fame acceptance. I don't know who'd induct him. Who could? Maybe Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels for the 25th anniversary and the career versus streak match that they had at WrestleMania's 20 and 21. Hell, I might have to go back and rewatch those two. I recently, within the last month or so, watched WrestleMania 20 from Houston. And, I'm sorry, WrestleMania, the 25th anniversary of WrestleMania, which was Shawn Michaels versus The Undertaker 1. And it still hits. Still hits pretty hard. And then you see Shawn Michaels put his career on the line. The Heartbreak Kid. Mr. Showstopper. Mr. WrestleMania. Couldn't do it. They didn't give it to him. They should have. They should have given Shawn Michaels the Undertaker's streak. And at that point, had him pick somebody. Hell, even if he retires, like kayfabe retires, comes out, says, "I beat The Undertaker. I can't believe it. I broke the streak." What else is there? Who else? What else is there? What other challenge could there possibly ever be for me? I'm done. Goodbye. Don't need it. And then when the right person comes along, HBK is there. HBK comes around, gets challenged by this person, and then he puts that person over by letting that person pin him. But that's just me. That's just some random dweeb on the internet talking about wrestling. Talking about a passion. My predictions for the rest of the wrestling year. We might... Aleister Black is going to face... I don't know that he is, but I think he is. I think... Aleister Black is going to face Andrade Cien Almas, and Almas is going to win. What's going to end up happening eventually is that Drew McIntyre is going to come back, because I think Black is just going to carry NXT on his back almost like a whole year. The Velveteen Dream. He's got skill, but no. He's going to be gone. He's going to be going up before winning an NXT championship, which is perfectly fine. You don't need to win the NXT championship before you get called up. In fact, I'd argue that there are several people who don't need to. And Aleister Black is one of them. But he's the top talent. He's better than Andrade Cien Almas. And I think that having him on the main roster to carry a show, hell, he could carry Raw. He could. He could do it better than Roman. And I don't like what they've done with Roman Reigns as a character. I don't. I have serious issues with the fact that they gave him a Royal Rumble. They gave him the one versus all gimmick for forever. They tried to bill him as a top guy when he clearly wasn't ready yet. They've missed opportunities to do interesting things with his character, i.e. they could have, if they would have made him a dick, if they would have made him a heel, a dickish heel, like he was in NXT, I would have been fine with it. And the character he's playing now, where he's cocky, he's, I am that damn good, it works. It's fine. People want to hate him because the company's made us hate him by saying, you are going to like this guy no matter what you have to say about it. We don't care. And they've blatantly admitted that they don't care what the fans think. And that's like, you're slapping the face of every paying customer that walks through those doors to say, we want to see certain people win titles, be featured more, and you won't do it. I mean, at least, I mean, when you watch, I mean, if there was ever a quintessential example of this, of the difference between what NXT does that makes people love NXT and what the main roster does, i.e. SmackDown and Raw, and how people don't like it, it's Shinsuke Nakamura. His first match in NXT was with Sami Zayn. They'd never met before, and they only wrestled once. NXT TakeOver Dallas, right before WrestleMania. Sami Zayn had been NXT champion. He'd lost it, took his rematch, lost that. His last match was Shinsuke. They had a 15-minute knockdown drag-out brawl that was really good. I believe Nakamura even got busted open. Busted open the hard way and kept going. It ended up, it was Sami. Sami Zayn got hit with one of Nakamura's stiff shots, and that's why he is the King of Strong Style in WWE. You don't have to be a genius to see why people would like that, why people would want to see more of it. It's because these guys are wrestling. These guys are putting on a physical contest, and you don't get that on the main roster. Speaking of, on the main roster, I can't count the number of times we've seen Kevin Owens, Sami Zayn versus Shinsuke Nakamura, Randy Orton in some form or fashion, but that does not include a singles match, Sami, Shinsuke. And he's been on the show every week. If it was NXT, you'd be lucky to see him once every three, once every two. You were not seeing him every week. When he was on, it was important. He had something to say. He had some challenge to issue or some reason to be there. Now he's just there. He wrestles. And yeah, Shinsuke can put on a damn good match. But I think it's time for Vince and Kevin Dunn and all the people that work with him to stop booking main roster stuff, to take a long, well-deserved vacation, and go away and let Triple H and his team of writers that work on NXT take over for the main roster. And you know who else needs to wrestle again? Daniel Bryan. He needs to be given a good match against somebody who can handle that kind of match. And I think the only one that, I think the one that would have really, you know, sent it off would have been Daniel Bryan versus The Miz. It was a couple of months ago, but it would have been the best send off. But what do I know? Just some rando talking wrestling on the internets. And I can't pull up my notes for Monday Night Raw and go over those, but I think that Paige completely overshadows the two women they called up with her, and they need to be sent back down, as do pretty much all three of the other women on the Riot Squad. It's like, no, you ladies weren't ready. Ruby Riot? I think she can put together a good match. I think she's maybe not as good as... she's not good in the same sense that Nikki Cross is, or Ember Moon, or even Kairi Sane, but she's still good. If there was a women's mid-card title, I'd put her as an Intercontinental Champion. Absolutely. No hesitation. But she's not. And this Royal Rumble for the women that they're doing. Why? Why would you put that on them? It's never been done because it didn't need to be done. Am I going to watch it? Yeah. Because I'm going to watch the Royal Rumble. But there's only one person who's going to win that Royal Rumble. And that's Asuka. Because they got to get Asuka to WrestleMania to face the champion, to win it undefeated. She's never been beaten. She needs that coronation. This is a person who was a 500 plus day reigning NXT Women's Champion. She could not be beaten. She could not be submitted. She was taken to the limit a number of times. A couple times, especially with the fatal four-way between Nikki Cross, the two divas, I don't remember their name, Billie Kay and Peyton Royce, and Asuka. Why didn't Billie Kay lay down for Peyton Royce? It's a fatal four-way. Just take the pinfall. Your friend gets to be NXT Women's Champion. Why not just do it? Why not just let her be champ and proclaim yourself co-champs? But no, they couldn't do it. Couldn't have it. The last woman standing match, which was her last match in NXT between Asuka and Nikki Cross, was... Whew! God, it was good. But, again, Ruby Riott's not that good yet. She could be. She could get, she could get the polish that she needs and develop into a great character, but she doesn't need lackeys. She's not that kind of heel. And Paige shouldn't need anybody. Again, what do I know? I'm just a big bearded rando talking wrestling on the internets. But I want to thank you all for watching. Please follow. You can follow me on Twitter, right there. Pinkie Pie Brony, with the first I being replaced with a 1. That's all caps. You can go to my YouTube channel. I don't have enough subscribers yet to have my own custom URL, but if you type in Rob Drapp or Robert Drapp, you should see yours truly with the Rob's Random ROMs. I didn't do it here today because, I didn't do a normal Rob's Random ROMs that I would do if you go over there and watch it, because I had a long day today. I had to work my other job, and I have to work tomorrow, which is Christmas Eve, and then we're doing Christmas party. So, again, as I said on that channel, as I believe I said yesterday as well, I don't know what's going to come up, and I don't think I'll be having the time to put together any kind of Christmas episode, but I want to thank, again, thanks for watching. I want to wish you all happy holidays, whatever you celebrate. Happy insert seasonally appropriate holiday here. And I will see you all next time.